I know what you're thinking. Didn't he just do one of these? Yes, I did. The Monday after I shot that last video, I went out and all this was in the mailbox. So I don't want to let it linger long enough to put some space between the videos. I want to get into these because I'm probably going to use them for something. So let's get at her. What's hiding under there? Computer accessories, it says. Okay. That could be just about anything. But I wasn't expecting Flux to be that anything. Soldering Flux. Pasty. Okay. Well, that's useful. I've got some liquid flux in a pen here. It runs all over the place when you use it. It's good for stuff. But I've never tried the paste type flux, so I'll give this a shot. 50 grams of rosin soldering flux with all these other description words for hits. Cost me $2.23 Canadian. It seems to have been priced in Canadian dollars. Yay, yay. From Baba Store Ong Storong Strong something. Free shipping from China. And what do we got to say about it? Not too much. Just the size of it. It's 100% brand new, which is very nice. But nothing that wasn't on. Actually, there's more information on the package. So 50 grams of flux. All right, next thing, repair tools. Worth what? 75 cents American, it says. We'll see about that. Clink. Oh, it's a couple of spudgers. Okay. Nice and solid. Fairly thick blade on the end of it. It's as thick as an X-Acto knife. Now this isn't giving me any challenge because it's. Do I have anything that needs a spudger to open it? Not really. That's an oversight. Oh well, these will definitely see some use coming up in the future. And I got two of them. I know I've ordered two different kinds, actually. But this is a package of two, so that's kind of useful. Two metal spudgers, repair opening tool, blah blah blah. They say for Apple iPhone 3, 3GS, 4, whatever. It's never going anywhere near an Apple product ever, mostly because there aren't any in the house. But that's a digression. From Baba Store Ong again, free shipping from China, $1.74 Canadian. Interesting that this guy prices his stuff in Canadian dollars. So 100% brand new, made of metal. With non-slip handle. Oh, it's got a few ridges anyway. Allows you to open covers, yeah. 122 by 12 millimeters, 12 grams. Package weighs 22 grams, which makes sense because there's two of them. No, wait, that doesn't make sense. That would be 24. Whatever. EB math. Thing the next. It is electronic parts and other electronic parts. That's a part. Okay, oh. This thing is many things. Okay. Oh. Kits. Yahooey. Let's see what we got here. Okay, this looks an awful lot like a stepper motor driver or. Step Super Motor Driver Board Module for 4-phase, 5-line Arduino and 28BYJ48, which is that cheap little stepper motor that shows up in all the basic Arduino kits. How come a mouse behave? 5 to 12 volts DC on the motor load side, presumably only 5 volts on your microcontroller side. 4 phases. Reduction ratio 1 to 64. Not quite sure what that means. Maybe current. I don't know. Doesn't matter. It shouldn't. There shouldn't really be a ratio of anything from input to output. I don't know why they even say that. 600 hertz with no load, 1 kilohertz with load, pulling torque, detent torque, what? They're talking about the motor that they think you might be using with this, not the actual module. Onboard stepper motor direct connection, yeah. Noise, again, really? These descriptions are sometimes useful and other times just complete random gibberish. And now then, the other thing in that same package from that same seller and kit. Put that up there. Hey, capacitor, what are you doing? So, what does that board have to say for itself? Aha! 555 timer chip. CD4017, which is a counter. So, you just clock it. And with each pulse, it sets a different output high. It's a decade counter, is what it's called. So, 10 of the pins are connected to these 10 LEDs via the resistors, I'm guessing. That's 10 of the... I think it's a 14-pin chip. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 16-pin chip. So 2 of them are power. 10 of them are outputs. So that's 12. There's, just from memory, there's a chip enable and there's a reset. And a couple of things are tied together here and there. But anyway, I'll put that together one of these days. And we'll play with it and see what we can do about it. I'm just going to zoom back out a little bit here. Take a look at all the stuff that's spilled out. So we got sockets for the two ICs. Got a bunch of LEDs. There's the 4017. There's the 555 with a bent pin. Fix that later. So pile of resistors. Except most of them are gonna be current limiting resistors. That 10 there. Ah. That 10, 2, 4, 6, 8. Yeah, that's 10. That's the current limiting resistors for the diodes, or LEDs. These two, I can't read them from here, but they're going to be part of the oscillator circuit, as is one of those two caps, or maybe both of them, actually. And then a couple of header pins for power. Ooh, and a variable resistor, presumably. What do we got there? 503, 50, and 3 more zeros, 50K. That's going to be probably for the speed of the, that's not the chip, of this, the 555 oscillator. That's a nice beginner circuit. Oh, yeah. Now that I've described what it does just by complete guesswork, there's the actual circuit. Battery power coming in, yeah. Ah, there's the ceramic capacitor, so it's just decoupling. I guessed wrong. Over here is the electrolytic capacitor, the variable resistor, and there we go, 4.7K and 2.2K. So that's the oscillator. It makes a square wave that goes into the 417, and it just pulses all the, or turns these guys on in sequence. There's other stuff that you can do too. Yeah, that's bill of lading. That's just in Chinese. Don't care. Okay, now I've rambled on about that for far too long. Let's go take a look at the listing. Two pieces, NE555 and CD417 LED DIY kit. I don't know why it's water, why they're talking about water. It's LED lights. There's no water involved in making this product or the use of it, especially not the use of it. So a pair of them for $2.60 Canadian or $1.96 for you Southerners out there. What? Oh, where is that from? That was from Alice 110, 1983. So what do we say about it down here? Ooh, kit model, LSD-10. Nice, psychedelic. Supply voltage between 3 and 4.5 volts. Pretty sure it'll take 5 volts. Kit mainly by clock generation circuit and decimal counter circuit constitute by 555. I'm not going to read through all that Chinglish. But basically it gives a description of the circuit, not unlike what we saw on the schematic and what I described from pure guesswork. LED module. Okay. What LED module did I order? Well, that doesn't really narrow it down. I ordered lots of LED modules. What was that? When I first saw them this way up, I thought they looked like knockoff Lego bricks or something. These are actually itty bitty breadboards of an assortment variety. They're obviously meant to peg into something, which I don't know what it is. But let's get a couple of bits of wire here and just see what goes where on them. Let's see, now where's one that's easy to read? Well, none of them really are, but can we see that? No, looks like it says 1, 2, 3 across there, across those middle rows, which is weird. So that's row 0 and that's row 4 or something. I don't know. But get out ye meter and just do a quick strip it on a random bit of wire that was lying around on the bench. And see what happens here. So, are these set up as columns or rows? Or are they all just gridded together? Ah, that's hard to push in there. These are probably that same kind of crappy ones that Julie and I encountered in larger quantities. Okay, so nothing happens there. So maybe they run this way. Ah, there we go. Okay. So, they run that way. Let's just do that to mark them that way. This one I ordered so long ago, March 8. It's now almost July when I'm recording this. Actually it's probably the beginning of July when you're watching it, but I ordered it on March 8, so it's been here so long it's just fallen completely off, and it's expired, and I can't click on it and get the details for you and anything. But it was $1.83, which is cheap. When I go at the view similar, there's even cheaper ones, $1.46. Who's selling those? Clickety click, blah blah blah. Okay, so somebody else is selling them even cheaper. Cool. Oh, actually, since we're here, let's see how they describe it. 25 pieces or 25 points, yeah. 25 holes. can be recycled. Doesn't say an awful lot about it that I didn't already say when I was poking around on it. Gift. Commercial value, $5. Wow, that's a nice gift from China. Wonder what it is. Oh, that looks like it's Uno size, but it's not an Uno. What are we? Some kind of a shield. Okay. What did I order for a shield? I don't remember, but I'm going to grab that Uno again. That Uno is actually in a little cheap plastic case that I got a while ago, but I didn't think it was exciting enough to open on camera. But so that'll stack on there. And what have we got? The analog pins show up there. We've got a buzzer, a connection labeled servo, connection labeled Bluetooth. Set of female header pins here labeled motor A and motor B. Oh, M A and M B, and then some screw terminals labeled motor A and motor B. And this over here is labeled UMS and ground, which have fairly chunky buses on the back of them. Okay. Some different pins over there. Reset button. What's on the back? Other than some foam to protect the pins from bending, which seem to have failed at their job. So I'm not going to be able to plug this in right away today. I'm going to straighten those guys out. But some back here looks like a regulator. Okay. So is that a motor shield, perhaps? Going to have to go do some digging. Oh, and there's some LEDs labeled green or yellow, green, yellow, and red down there. There's another one that's not labeled down there. A jumper that's called option. 74, in a couple of spots on here, it says 74HC1G04, which focus. And then there's that big IC there. To the listing. So this board was in fact a DC motor module 2 amp H bridge times two-way, two-channel, I guess, which would be what the big chip in the middle is. But again, it's almost July. I ordered this in February and it just showed up. Man, shipping is just all over randomness. Ignore the price, ignore the seller. This is just three of the same one that I got. So, let's see if it has anything intelligent to say about it. There is an L298P motor driver chip on the board. So you can use digital pins, something, 10, 11, and 12. Okay, there's an onboard buzzer on D4. This is useful information. Convenient motor input. You can use two routes, motor output. The 2-way Bluetooth interface. Yeah, I saw that. 7-digit interface that are not occupied. So digital pins 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 9, and D bracket. Does that say anything hidden under there? No. Okay. So detective work to do because don't know what those two mean. Has 6 analog interfaces. Yeah, we saw that broken out on the board. And actually, they were broken out on nice little color-coded ones, too. I guess they were. And it has an indicator for forward, backward, and changing direction, which I assume is those red and green LEDs that I... green and yellow LEDs that I pointed out on the board. Okay. That's actually, well, three-quarters useful. All right. Next and last for today. Electronic components, no commercial value, $3. I already started on this, but I still haven't looked at what it is. Okay, that's empty. Okay, these are little adapter boards. You put a surface mount SOP 16 chip on there and then run it out to breadboard friendly dip switches. Where's a handy dandy little breadboard here? Not dip switches, what am I talking about? Breadboard friendly dip headers. Yeah, that lines up nicely. Okay. Oh, and on the back, you could optionally put a SSOP 16, the finer pitch 16 pin. Neat. And what else is in the package? Can I zoom in any further? Can you see what those are? Okay, I'll zoom you back out again, and I'll selfishly look in my magnifying glass here, under the real light. Yeah, come on. Oh, they're CD4017s. These are decade counters. These are the same chip that's in these kits that I just got, except for they're the surface mount version. Huh. So I can tinker some of them up on a breadboard. And if I ever decide to get cross-eyed, I can make me a surface mount board for chasing lights or sequencing things or whatnot. As much as it's cool to play with Arduinos, I'm still from the old school. I grew up on analog electronics and discrete components, so I still like to play with those as much as I can, just because I can. Let's take a peek at the listing for these guys. 10 pieces IC adapter board for all these different shapes of surface mount IC, which is really just two of them, but they've got multiple descriptors because they're trying to drag clicks in from King Electronics 15, who I've bought a bunch of stuff from before and have never had any problems with. Chip spacing. Again, there's nothing really to say about those. It's just a little adapter circuit board. 10 pieces CD4017BM, which I assume is the descriptor of the surface mount package and not describing the medical BM about the quality of them or anything like that. Ooh, that was lame, sorry. Anyway. SOP 16, which fits nicely onto those little breadboard adapters, and as I said, it is a counter divider. When I get to experimenting with these later, I'll show you how to use it for those two different things. The absolute classic thing for this chip is a chase light circuit, though, and that's where I'm going to be starting. And there is today's mailbag. Nice little assortment of stuff. Glad I opened them. Hope you don't mind having a couple of these mailbags in rapid succession, but I had fun with it. Talk to you later.